My name is Mark Rawlings, and I'm a general partner here at the Baker Hotel, and I'm also the general contractor who's in charge of the restoration. I've been doing hotel restoration work and resorts since the mid-90s, and the Baker Hotel is one I've been wanting to do since 2008, so we're happy to be rolling on it. The hotel property became involved in 2008, and we came out here and started checking it out and seeing what budgets would be, how we would be able to put this thing together and make sure it would work. And so from 2008 to 2019, we did a lot of studies on it, and we bought it in 2019 and began doing some of the restorative tasks here. This hotel was built started construction in 1926. It finished in 1929, a week before the crash of the stock market, which was unfortunate timing, but it was still was in its heyday in the 30s, 40s, and 50s. It closed down in 1963 because Mr. Baker said he was retiring at 70 and was done. So it closed down for a few years, and then some local investors came together and pooled together some money and reopened it until 1972, and then it was closed for good. And it sat abandoned for 49 years now, waiting on somebody to come put it back together. We're gonna be a full luxury hotel and spa facility. So we have an entire floor dedicated to spa, and it'll be great for wedding venues, meetings, corporate meetings, any event that anybody wants to have, and just a fun place to stay. We're restoring the pool. We'll have three different ballrooms available, two different restaurants, retail shops on the ground floor. So we think we'll be a full service resort hotel. The thing I love most about this industry is, you know, working with your hands and getting the reward and the payoff when you see a job that's been restored and complete. When you take it from this to something that's great, it's very rewarding. It's something different every day. We don't necessarily know what we're gonna come across, and we just put our boots on and deal with what we can every day to make the best product we can at the end of the day. Yeah, construction, we make a lot of dust. This is one of the big problems that we have, and then just trying to stay cool and trying to be comfortable. We've restored the windows, they're back in. We don't have air conditioning and won't have for a couple of years, and so we need to do anything we can do to have some of the creature comforts. So moving some air through here definitely helps us as far as keeping cool, and having some air purification knock down the dust is always a great thing. So far, the things that we've enjoyed the most are being the mobility of them, that they're much lighter than what we're used to. They push a lot of air, so we get a lot of good air circulation, and the purification of the air. We make so much dust, anything we can do to knock that down, and they've done a really good job for us. Yeah, I would say the best thing to do is buy more than one. You can keep a lot of people cool with them, and the more filtration, the better. We want to keep everybody healthy here and comfortable. So buy a lot, they're great. One of the biggest benefits and our hopes for this hotel is this community. We want to see the community come back to life, because we know that Mineral Wells, when the Baker went away and ceased operations and the Army base closed here, the town really had a depressed economy, and we've seen it, you know, that it suffered quite a bit from all of that. One of the benefits is there's so many historical buildings left downtown, and many towns would tear those down and be big box stores and have completely revitalized in a different, ugly way. And so we still have all the old charm here, and we want to have the Baker restored. The downtown business is going into all of the other historic buildings down here, and making this a destination that people will want to come, not just to the hotel, but enjoy the community. And we want to see the community bounce back with us.